Hi, everybody. This is Lisa.
And this is Joe.
And welcome to Your Cheap Date for August 5th, 2006.
That's Cheap Date, the show that asks the question.
Dawn, if you're the maitre d', you must know who's at all the tables.
I certainly do.
I need to know where to sit Lisa and Joe, so you'll have to tell me all the names, and then I'll know who's sitting at what tables.
Oh, I'll tell you all the names, but you know, it seems that nowadays people have very peculiar names.
You mean funny names?
Yeah, let's see. Who's at the first table? What's at the second table? I don't care, is at the third.
That's what I want to find out.
I said, who's at the first table? What's at the second table? I don't care, is at the third.
Are you the manager also?
Yes.
And you don't know the people's names?
Well, I should.
Well, then who's at the first table?
Yes.
I mean the fellow's name.
Who?
The guy at the first table.
Who?
The first table.
Who?
The guy eating at the first table.
Who is eating at the first table?
I'm asking you, who's at the first table?
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
Look, you got a first table.
Certainly.
Who's eating at the first table?
That's right.
Okay, when you bring out the food, who gets the food?
Yes, all of it.
All I'm trying to find out is the fellow's name at the first table.
Who?
The guy that gets...
That's it.
Who gets the food?
He does, every plate, and sometimes his wife comes in and eats with him.
Whose wife?
Yes. What's wrong with that?
Look, all I want to know is when you bring him the bill, how does he sign his name?
Who?
The guy.
Who?
How does he sign?
That's how he signs it.
Who?
Yes.
All right. All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name at the first table?
No, what is at the second table?
I'm not asking you who's at the second table.
Who's at the first table?
Listen, one table at a time.
Well, don't change the people around.
I'm not changing nobody.
Take it easy, buddy.
I'm only asking you who's the guy at the first table.
That's right.
Okay.
All right.
Is the third table empty?
No, empty is the cook.
I'm not asking you who's the cook.
Who's at the first table?
I don't know.
He's the dishwasher. We're not talking about him.
Now, how did I get to the dishwasher?
You mentioned his name.
If I mention the dishwasher's name, who reserved the third table?
No. Who is sitting at the first table?
What's at the first table?
What's at the second table?
I don't know.
He's the dishwasher.
There I go back to the dishwasher again. Would you just stay on the third table and don't go off it?
All right, what do you want to know?
Now, is the third table empty?
Why do you insist on putting empty on the third table? He's the cook.
What? Because Lisa and Joe needs to sit down.
No, what is at the second table?
So no one is at the third table.
No one is parking cars.
I don't care.
I don't care is at the third table.
Is anyone at the fourth table?
No.
Good, it's empty.
No, empty is the cook.
Never mind. Lisa and Joe, your table is ready. Please follow me.
Okay, well.
Wow.
Thank you, Steve and Don.
We'll be lucky if we eat it all tonight.
With those two standing up there at the podium.
If the waitresses are as confused as the host persons.
Oh, my goodness. That, of course, was Steve and Don from the For What It's Worth podcast. So we want to thank you guys for sending that along.
Thank you. That is by far the most complicated call to the table ever submitted.
You're not kidding. But you know what? We needed a call to the table that was dramatic like that, because we got a big show for you tonight, folks.
A big show. The Big Show?
No, not The Big Show.
Just a big show.
I have a stack of papers right here. The places that we've gone, the places that we are, ladies and gentlemen. We in recent weeks we have taken you out for pizza. We have taken you out for hot dogs and Italian beef. We've taken you out for...
It is so summer, isn't it?
It is. And you know what we're going to do now? We're taking you out for dessert.
Yes.
Tonight, the Cheap Date Show takes you to some of our favorite ice cream places located around the Chicago area. Where do you want to start, honey?
Every ice cream place is my favorite.
I'm going
to
lay
let's start with this. Let's start with a little Lisa and Joe ice cream setup.
Okay.
Joe, what's your favorite kind of ice cream? What do you get when you go out for ice cream?
What do I get typically?
I mean, assuming that you don't have to resort to non-dairy creamer.
You're never going to let me forget that, are you?
No.
Okay.
And I told some people at work, and they can't wait to give you crap for it.
I was a kid.
That's what I said. Cut him some slack. He was 8.
No, I was older than that, but that's
okay. Well, I was trying to help you out.
When I go out for ice cream, depending on where I go, but in general, what I judge a lot of ice cream places on are either a vanilla malt, or sometimes I'll just get a nice vanilla ice cream cone. Depending. Soft serve, I usually tend to go vanilla with a dip.
Chocolate dip.
Right, chocolate dip or other flavor dips as we'll discover in a few moments.
Mm-hmm.
Or sometimes, if I'm really feeling wacky, a caramel sundae.
Ooh.
So.
And sometimes you'll go with like a cake batter or cookie batter dough, but you tend towards the cookie batter dough, cookie batter ice cream.
Right.
But you tend
cake
towards
batter
the vanilla.
Ice cream.
Right, or cookie dough. Right. That's what I meant. But yeah, you tend towards the vanilla.
Yes. And you, Lisa, this is like...
Duh. I am a big fan of chocolate. This
really? The devil, you say.
I used to always get just standard chocolate or like a chocolate brownie chunk or a chocolate fudge ripple or something like that. Lately, I've been hooked on chocolate peanut butter.
Oh, yeah.
Either with little crushed up peanut butter cups in it or with like a peanut butter ribbon. That peanut butter, like, as though chocolate weren't rich enough. First of all, they make their chocolate ice cream extra rich when there's peanut butter in it.
Right.
To stand up to it. And,
Well, a good ice cream plays well.
Yeah. And then the peanut butter adds even more richness.
Right.
So, I think I've had chocolate peanut butter at all of these places.
Oh, really?
At one time or another. Yeah. So, well, not at the two soft serve places.
Okay. So, where should
we'll get to that.
So, where should we start?
Well, let's start with a neighborhood favorite, Oberweis
Dairy. We've mentioned them on the show before.
We have. Joe, when I lived in Washington, Joe used to tell me that he went to Oberweis and got a malt for $4.25.
A vanilla malt. I was at the drive-thru.
And I was like, who pays $4.25 for a shake? I was thinking like a Frosty at best.
She actually asked me the question if it came with anything else. If it was just the
yeah, like
if it was
a
just
car.
The malt. But anyway, Oberweis is a the retail store is called Oberweis Dairy. There actually is an Oberweis Dairy with cows and the whole nine yards.
Right. And the stores you can buy milk and eggs and butter and such.
As we've said before, it's typical stuff you can buy from like your typical egg and butter man.
A dairy. Correct. But let's talk ice cream.
Okay. Well, here's the thing about Oberweis. They have sundaes. They have shakes and malts. They have sodas. They have floats. They have frostbites, which is similar to what Dairy Queen calls a blizzard. They have things called moo coolers, which are like ice cream smoothie type things. They do have smoothies. They have ice cream pies. Ice cream pies. And of course,
awesome.
Cups and cones. I'm looking for a list of flavors here. Oberweis is great because they're just like an old fashioned how I would imagine an old fashioned ice cream parlor is because you can order from the counter and
the atmosphere is fun.
Right. Go ahead.
Do they have a list of flavors?
I'm looking.
If I had to estimate, I'd say they have a dozen flavors.
Yeah.
They don't have the most comprehensive list you've ever seen, but they do have a wide variety of sundaes. And
sundaes are chocolate, strawberry, butterscotch, caramel, pineapple, marshmallow, raspberry, crushed Oreos, Heath Bar, Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, M&M's, Cookie Dough, Butterfingers, Snickers, all finished off with whipped cream and sprinkles, and on your request, a maraschino cherry.
Sprinkles.
Sprinkles.
What do we want to say about Oberweis? They do make an old-fashioned malt, complete with the malty powder.
Yes. And also, okay, here's the malts. Vanilla, chocolate, cherry, root beer.
Root beer?
There's a chain of ice cream places, and those of you who are in, I think it's primarily a Midwest chain called Cock Robin. Their claim to fame was square ice cream. They had scoops that were cut up in squares. And they used to have a root beer shake, which tasted exactly like pumpkin pie. I don't know why, but it was something about the spice, and it was delicious. There was one right here in Arlington Heights for many years. You used to stop there.
That sounds weird.
Vanilla, chocolate, cherry, root beer, banana, pineapple, strawberry, caramel, raspberry, and butterscotch
shakes.
Those
are all the malts and shakes?
Those are the malts and shakes.
Whoa. Okay, so plenty of variety.
Right.
We've established that.
The thing that makes their shakes really good is because, number one, they use whole milk. Number two, they use their ice cream is incredibly fresh. It's not soft serve. It's hard-packed, scooped.
Mm-hmm.
They use malt powder. They stick a little chocolate-filled pirouette cookie in it.
Oh.
And then they use heavy whipped cream. They don't use ready whip. They don't use the kind of stuff you get at the grocery store. They use real heavy cream in a big one of those big canisters with a little cartridge in it that puts it right on there.
Seriously, you drink this whole thing? First of all, you don't drink it. Let's be straight about that. But you get this whole thing down.
You go into lactose shock.
Yeah, seriously.
You seriously do.
Neither of us are lactose intolerant, but both of us have had the post-shake hangover.
Oh, yeah. But it's
there's a shoe in your stomach. That sounds awful. It's totally worth it.
Mm-hmm. And
maybe we should split one next time.
You know, let's do that. Now, here's the thing about Oberweis. They did start as a Chicago suburban, the western suburbs of Chicago. They have stores all over the Chicago area, north, south, east, and west. They even have one in Baldwin, Missouri, Carmel, Indiana, which is where my sister lives, Chesterfield, Missouri. Yeah, essentially the entire metro area. Oh, Schererville, Indiana.
You can get them all at oberweis.com.
Yes. It's a great place. Still a family-owned business. Started in 1951, I believe, is when they actually opened their first store.
Their ice cream is delightfully rich. All the places we're going to talk about have delightfully rich ice cream.
And we've also mentioned the fact that you can get stuff from there. That's where I usually buy my milk as well.
Yeah, and they give you glass bottles that you have to take back. It's kind of fun.
It's very cool.
Okay,
so that's Oberweis.
You pick the next one.
The next one we will go to is a south side of Chicago tradition, the Plush Horse.
Oh, the Frosty Pony.
The Frosty Pony. The Plush Horse is located in the southwestern suburb of Palos Park, Illinois.
Wait a minute. What the heck does a plush horse have to do with ice cream?
You know what?
Frosty Pony, I can understand.
Yeah, I know. It's hard to say.
No, but what I'm getting at is, why do they call it the plush horse?
Because there's a giant plush horse in the middle of the store that you can go up and pet. It even says
there
you
is.
Can,
it's like the size of a pony.
Mm-hmm. It's life size.
Like a real pony.
Mm-hmm. It's in a very quaint little area.
You can pet it, but you can't ride it.
That's right. It's in a quaint little area right near a forest preserve, so it's very wooded. And it's been there since 1937.
And more recently than that, they've added on a coffee shop, too. So that's
yes, they
cool.
have. Here are the flavors that we're looking at.
Oh, boy. Settle in.
These are all, again, these are not soft serve. These are scooped out of the big case. Almond amaretto, apple pie, banana, black cherry, black walnut, blue bubblegum, buttercream, butter pecan, butterfinger, cappuccino, chocolate almond, chocolate chip.
Oh.
Chocolate mint, chocolate mousse, cinnamon. That would be kind of interesting.
Huh.
Get a scoop of that and put it on like a piece of apple pie.
Oh.
Coffee, cookie dough, cookies and cream, eggnog, Hawaiian Delight. I've tasted that. That's like it's like a pina colada. It's like pineapple and coconut. Heath Bar, Italian Lemonade, Maple Nut, Orange, Peach, Peanut Butter Chocolate.
Oh, yeah.
Put a bookmark in that spot, folks, because Lisa's going to come back to that. Peppermint, Pistachio, Pumpkin Pie, Rocky Road, Rum Raisin, Strawberry, Strawberry Cheesecake, Vanilla, Vanilla Malt, which is what I had, which was, it was tasted just like a vanilla malt, only in ice cream form, and Watermelon. Lisa.
Ooh, watermelon.
Oh, and their slogan is, think inside the cone. Oh, they also added some new flavors, chocolate, cherry kiss, key lime pie, blueberry, raspberry, sherbet, no sugar added vanilla, no sugar added butter pecan, and no sugar added chocolate swirl.
Oh, forget that. No sugar added.
Tell us about peanut butter chocolate.
Delish. By the way, I always get it in a cup.
Yes.
Because cones end up all over me. And not in me.
But you're so cute when you have little shards of sugar going all over you.
And ice cream dripping down my fingers. No. The cup is much neater.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I've had some good cones in my time. Don't think I don't like cones. But, I mean, a cone is like, a really good cone is like a whole other dessert. It's just, I don't know. It distracts me. Anyhow. The chocolate peanut butter in a cup. It was delicious. It was rich. Nice, thick, salty peanut butter. You need the peanut butter a little salt. I mean, they use a... They don't use just, like, raw, regular peanut butter in these things. Oh, no. I take that back. What was different about the Plush Horse was that there was not a peanut butter ribbon. I just got a scoop of ice cream that was a pale brown, like a regular chocolate color.
Right.
And I tasted it, and it tasted like peanut butter... But there was no actual peanut butter in it. Which is to say there were no...
It wasn't like a vein of peanut butter running through it.
Right, there was not a peanut butter ripple like there typically is. It just had a peanut butter flavor. So it was really interesting because in every... The texture was consistent.
Texture, yes, ladies and gentlemen.
But when you... But in every bite, you got chocolate and peanut butter. Whereas with the ribbon... And I'm not saying I like one better than the other. Well, I think I like the ribbon better.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas with the ribbon, you get a bite of peanut butter and then three bites of chocolate.
Right. Similar to, in effect, to eating a Reese's peanut butter cup.
Yes. Where there the two are separate.
There are discrete zones. You got your chocolate zone. You got your peanut butter
zone.
And if
you want to try to eat all of one first, or if you want to suck the peanut butter out, whatever you want to do, you can try to separate them.
Wow.
Like the marshmallows and the Lucky Charms. But they kind of get melded together. They complement each other. You really can't mess it up. But the Plush Horse ice cream was even more foolproof. You could not get one without the other.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of wonder how they did that. I wonder how they got the peanut butter dissolved in there.
I'm sure it has to do with the manufacturing process. I'm just taking a stab here.
Captain Obvious.
Thank you.
And I had a taste of your vanilla malt. It was very vanilla-y and malty.
Yes, it was like it was a very high quality, very dense vanilla ice cream, very creamy vanilla ice cream. Because you can get, I've had vanilla ice creams that are kind of crystally, and that's typically more what they used to call ice milk until I believe the FDA raised the restriction on using that term, ice milk.
Mm-hmm.
But this was a very creamy, very dense, not really airy. Vanilla ice cream, which had like the carnation malted milk powder blended right into it. So, oh.
That's true about Plush Horse is the ice cream was almost like custard.
Mm-hmm.
It was, we'll be getting to that later.
I'm sensing a segue.
Now, are you ready for a segue?
Not yet. Oh. We have to say that the Plush Horse is located at 12301 South 86th Avenue in Palos Park. It's south of where we are, but... Worth the trip.
Yes. Now, if you want real live custard, Julianne's frozen custard.
Oh my goodness.
Out in where? Crystal Lake?
Crystal Lake, and then they have a franchise one out in Woodstock.
Now, can I just tell you how I went into the frozen custard experience?
Please do.
I had never had frozen custard until you took me to Julianne's. I had driven by frozen custard places, and I had had frozen yogurt. And I had had ice cream. So when I heard frozen custard, I thought frozen yogurt.
Uh-huh.
And I could not have been more wrong.
It's sort of like talking about a Tombstone pizza versus like a
it's like
Tortorizzi's pizza.
Yeah. I don't even know what it's like. But frozen yogurt is nothing compared to frozen custard.
Frozen custard is thick, has a larger, I believe it has a larger egg content.
The order would be frozen yogurt, ice cream. Frozen custard is on the other side of ice cream.
Yes, it is. Extremely dense, extremely sweet, and very, very, I'm sure, loaded with fat.
No air in it at all.
No.
It's like pudding,
mm-hmm.
only frozen.
Right. Well, yeah, it's extremely creamy. It's the smoothest thing you'll ever put in your mouth. If I may.
Oh, okay.
If I may be so bold.
Somebody touched Joe's texture button. Mm-hmm.
The way that it's served is it's not served the way that packed ice cream is in the big, you know, the half or the gallon or the 5 gallon, you know, tubs that they mm-hmm. pull them out of the coolers. This actually comes out of a machine and then it's put into it's softer. It's between, from a consistency standpoint, it's in between the soft serve and the it's in between soft serve and the hand packed stuff.
Right. It's not like when it melts, it doesn't get it doesn't melt as fast, it seems, as soft serve.
Right.
It doesn't have the water content, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Once it's frozen, it really stays frozen. But right, you don't have to bite into it.
Right.
You can just lick it, which is good for me. I have very cold, sensitive teeth.
Mm-hmm.
In case you cared.
Exactly. Now, the thing about Julianne's is that for the frozen custard, they make 3 flavors. Vanilla, chocolate, and their flavor of the day, which
That's
we've seen...
too many flavors for me, buddy.
Well, there you go. And the flavor of the day varies from strawberry to various other things as well. And then the idea is that you get your sundae or your shakes or your whatever made out of that. My favorite thing to get there is the caramel sundae, which is just glop of vanilla, frozen custard, with caramel sauce and whipped cream and a cherry. Oh.
Needless to say, my favorite thing is chocolate. And as I recall, it's not the most chocolatey ice cream I've ever had.
No.
It's chocolate more along the lines of a frosty or a soft serve,
mm-hmm.
in terms of the intensity of the chocolate flavor.
Right.
But... if you made it any more rich, you would just die. So that is fine.
Right. And they have all the, as you would expect, they have something called the tortoise sundae, which, as you can imagine, is hot fudge, caramel, and pecans.
Oh.
And they run the complete gamut in terms of sundaes. They have their own version of a blizzard called a concrete, which is Oreo, Reese's Peanut Butter Cup, Reese's Pieces, or Snickers, Butterfingers, Whoppers, M&M, Heath Bars, Nerds, Cherry, Raspberry, Hot Fudge, Chocolate, Strawberry, Banana, Mocha, Coffee, Marshmallow, Caramel, Peanut Butter, Pineapple, and Butterscotch.
Wow. And Julianne's, do they have a drive-thru? They do.
They do. They do indeed.
They're kind of one of those walk-up ice cream stand things with some picnic tables and stuff.
Inside. They have tables inside.
Inside, but not a lot, do they?
No. And they have little benches outside that you can sit on. It's up on Northwest Highway in Crystal Lake. So just as Plush Horse is kind of far south, this is a little bit further northwest of the Chicago area. So 4817 North Northwest Highway in Crystal Lake, Illinois, will take you to Julianne's Frozen Custard. Next.
Biggity bam. Let's do Glenview Dairy Bar next.
Okay.
This is a little tiny place you just walk up, right?
Mm-hmm. It is.
They have, it's not on here, but they had a list of dip flavors that that astounded me.
Mm-hmm.
Grape bubblegum, grape cotton candy, I don't remember.
Rainbow sprinkle.
It's a soft serve place. Okay, this is your classic neighborhood walk-up ice cream spot.
Right. similar to a Dairy Queen,
they
only not a Dairy Queen.
They don't make their own ice cream right there on site. They don't have one of those big coolers with 90 flavors.
No, they got the machine. They add the mix into the machine, soft serve.
Yeah. That said, my soft serve was like 9 inches tall.
Yeah.
And I didn't leave a bit of it behind.
And didn't they say, wasn't there a sign that said that their soft serve was 90-something percent fat-free or 80-something percent fat-free?
Yeah, they did.
So.
I wish we had a little more information about it in front of us. They also had one of those menus that was like you would have to stand there for an hour to read the whole menu.
Right.
So you skim until you see something that looks good and you try it.
It was all ice cream, though. There's no other food on that menu. It was all ice cream items. They didn't have burgers and fries and stuff like that.
They had more ice cream options than I could even imagine.
And it was packed. And the picture that is on the blog this week is of the Glenview Dairy Bar that we went there. So you'll get to actually see what it looks like from there. Again, it's a little building. It's a walk-up place. It's kind of out of the way. If you don't really know where it is, you totally miss it. And it's only open in the summertime, too. It's not open in the winter. So,
how much more can we say about ice cream?
About Glenview Dairy Bar? It's a great place. It's a good little neighborhood place if you're in the Glenview area. You can certainly stop by there. It's definitely worth the trip, and it's a great option. Mm-hmm. Great alternative to, you know, stopping and getting a $4 Frappuccino at Starbucks.
Yeah, it's better than Dairy Queen. It's a more creative option than Baskin-Robbins.
Right.
That's all.
Okay, so there you go. Glenview Dairy Bar, 1015 Harlem Avenue, just north of Glenview Road in Glenview, Illinois.
Now, I humbly submit that we have saved the best for last. You don't have to agree, but that's my opinion. Capannari ice cream in Mount Prospect.
I need the golf clap. I don't know why.
Let me start by saying that the chocolate peanut butter I got from Capannari was... Actually, it's double chocolate peanut butter, and it is nearly black.
Yes.
And it's the fourth grade favorite, according to the bar chart on the wall, tied with cookie dough.
That's true.
So I went with the fourth grade mentality and ordered that. Amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had anything, well, never's a strong word, but... I cannot think of ever having had ice cream with a more intense flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely amazing. Nice salty ripple of hard peanut butter and just the ridiculously rich chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
And the atmosphere is awesome. Why don't you give us a little background on the Capannari's building?
Here's the story of the Capannari's building. It's, as Lisa said, it's in Mount Prospect. It's located on Pine Street, which is actually not the original location of where that building stood. That building was originally right in the center of downtown Mount Prospect at the corner of Northwest Highway and Elmhurst Road at the northeast corner. It was one of the oldest buildings in the area, in the town. It was originally the home of... Hold on a second.
It was the post office, the blacksmith shop, the general store, the pharmacy, maybe.
Oh, yeah, it was several things. Oh, here we go. The old general store and post office, built in 1882. The 19th century building was authentically restored to look much like it did in its early days. What they did... Oh, I was actually in this building when I was a young man because it was a record store called Hotter Than Mother's Music, also known as Mother's. But that's where we used to buy our LPs back in the day.
Your records.
Our records. My brother claims to have purchased the very first copy of Dark Side of the Moon ever sold in the northwest suburbs of Chicago because he was there in the store when the box came and he bought the first copy out of the box for whatever that's worth.
How old was he when he told this story?
But
because you pretty much can't believe anything a guy says between the ages of... 10 and like
90.
30.
So what they did was somebody a few years ago, probably like maybe 7 or 8 years ago, there was an accident. Somebody hit the building, and the village said, okay, we're just going to demolish this building. And then some people got together and said, no, you know what? This is an historic building standing right there
in the way of the cars.
This is a historic building. So what they did was they got some funds together, and a bunch of people, a bunch of local businesses donated their time and efforts and whatnot, and they actually moved the building about two blocks northwest of where it stood, and then they completely refurbished it.
So now it's in a safe little place with a park next door.
Mm-hmm. It's not in such a precarious location. And oddly enough, the spot where the building used to be, they put up a whole huge condo complex, and in that condo complex is an Oberweis Dairy.
Circle of life.
I know. For what it's worth. Hey, there's another circle of life.
I didn't see Oberweis looking very crowded that day that we were down there.
So that's the little history of the building. And I should mention Mount Prospect is the town right next door to where we live.
And Capannari makes all of their own. So does the Plush Horse, I think. Capannari makes all their own ice cream right there on site.
They do indeed.
Well, and so does Oberweis, but I mean, Oberweis is a bigger operation. Mm-hmm. Capannari, there is a dude upstairs mixing up ice cream.
Literally on the second floor of the building.
And he... I'd like to shake his hand.
You'd like to lick his hand. Let's get down to that. The flavors of the month are peach, coconut, chip, pistachio, ginger, green tea, lindenberry sorbet, chocolate sorbet, peach melba yogurt, vanilla yogurt, raspberry yogurt, cherry lime Italian ice. You said you had the
double chocolate peanut butter.
Right. What did I have?
Cookie dough?
Did I have cookie? I don't think I had cookie dough.
I think Emma had cookie dough.
Emma had cookie dough. Oh, I had the dulce de leche.
That's right.
Oh, my God. Yes, I was in sugar shock after that, too. Now, the cool thing about Capannari is also, another cool thing about them is the fact that they switch out their flavors every month. And last summer when we were there, I had a taste of this, but I didn't actually order a cone of it. They had Guinness-flavored ice cream. Do you remember that? Oh.
I read on one of the things on the wall that they had broccoli one time.
Yeah, they did. So that's pretty cool.
It was really quite good.
Mm-hmm.
So for definitely your creative flavor pick, I highly recommend green tea ice cream if you're looking for something rich and creamy but a little bit gentler.
And high in antioxidants.
And high in antioxidants. So is dark chocolate.
That's a good point. The higher the cocoa content, the more antioxidant.
That's my...
No, I think that's been clinically proven, and we have listeners who will substantiate this for us, so we don't even need to do the research.
Okay. Listeners, substantiate. Thank you.
We need a substantiate signal. Bing, bing, bing. Substantiate. Another cool thing about... I don't even know what that means. Another cool thing about...
No more Star Trek for you.
Another cool thing about Capannari's is that they have wacky little special events going on all year long. So, for instance, if I can throw
like
a
ice cream eating contests,
they have things like that. They show movies. The side of the building is white, so they project movies on the side of the building. In fact, a couple weeks ago, they showed the movie Nanny McPhee. I remember last summer they showed, I think it was Toy Story, and Finding Nemo, one of the movies. They have a every Sunday night. They have they call it a Bagos tournament.
Oh, beanbags.
Beanbags or whatever you call those, because that's become like the big thing now.
Bags, I think, is what they're typically called.
Bags, dude. On June 25th, and Lisa missed this, they had a rock, paper, scissor tournament. I know.
Where was I? I am the world champion. The unknown world champion.
Of rock, paper, scissors? That was on June 25th.
You want to go right now?
Yeah, we'll go right now. They have, hold on, but what I'm just going to point out, they have a Hawaiian night. Actually, coming up. This is, August 5th? They're showing the movie Dreamer. I never heard of that movie.
No, me neither.
On August 8th. And on August 3rd, which was Thursday night, they had a DDR tournament.
Ooh.
Should have brought the kids over there.
That would have been fun.
So anyway, that's Capannari's ice cream. Okay, quick rock, paper, scissors. Lisa claims to be the champ. Oh!
Joe's a scissor man.
I always start with my scissors, and she starts with rock.
Scissors are delicate and crafty. They're not The rock is brute force. The paper is passive aggressive.
Okay, one more time.
You are delicate and crafty.
Ah! I beat her that time. We both did...
Oh, I guess that's not very fun for our listeners. We both did paper, and then I did rock, and Joe did paper.
So there you go. All right, so okay, so
I should have known.
All right, best of three.
Wait.
Here's the key to rock, paper, scissors, especially playing against someone like Lisa who takes this real seriously. Don't let her concentrate. Just go right into it.
Okay.
We're getting lots of rocks here, guys. Oh! We had four rocks in a row, and then I threw a paper out, and I beat her. So best of three.
That's like
Joe's the champion.
Oh, stop it. We'll go later. We should do it for shots.
Capannari's is located at 10 South Pine Street, Mount Prospect, Illinois. Check it out.
Banana split for my baby, a glass of plain water for me. Banana split for my baby, glass of plain water for me. Dispenser man, if you please, serve my chick a mess of calories. Banana split for my baby, a glass of plain water for me.
That's our whirlwind tour right now, and I know there are places we've forgotten. There are calories. There are calories unconsumed. There are lots and lots and lots of other places that we would like to mention on here, but time won't allow, unfortunately.
No, those are just a few of the highlights. We would love to hear where you go for ice cream in your neck of the woods.
Yes, we would. And what your favorite remembrances of ice cream and dessert places and fun places to go in the summer would be.
Mm-hmm. Favorite summer foods, favorite ice cream flavors.
Mm-hmm. What the best way of taking off pounds would be after eating all this stuff.
Yeah, no kidding.
And also, don't forget, we also love hearing your comments and also the guest reviews. Again, we said it last week, we'll say it again. We do have some guest reviews backlogged. We do apologize, but we promise that we will have them up on future shows.
Yeah, it takes us a while to get through that stuff sometimes. And like Steve and Don sent that call to the table in like months ago.
Yeah.
We just had to wait for the right show for it.
And you know what? They had the perfect show for it.
Yes.
So there it is.
Our goal is to showcase your guest review or call to the table.
That's right.
To its fullest potential.
Wow. I'm impressed. I'm going to send in a guest review.
That's not really our goal, but.
Well, it's a goal.
We do try to make it a good fit.
It's worthwhile. Where can they send those guest reviews and yada, yada, yadas, Lisa?
Dish. At cheapdateshow.com.
Right.
I don't know what that was all about.
I like that, though. And you can visit the blog at cheapdateshow.com as well. Is there anything else we need to mention before we say goodnight to these fine folks?
I don't think so.
Just to thank them for listening and thank them for being them. Thank them for being... Thank you for letting us into your earbuds.
Wow.
Dudes. There goes Mom.
Or your car stereo or whatever.
Or wherever you listen to us.
Thanks for letting us hang out with you.
Yeah. Hey.
You gotta, super.
You should probably clean this car up a little bit, though. Is it like a Dunkin' Donuts cup back there?
Okay.
All right. So I guess that's going to wrap it up, folks.
Yep.
Have a good week.
Stay cool. It is hot everywhere. Although by the time this comes out, it should have cooled off a little.
Yeah. So enjoy the week, and we'll talk to you next time.
Good night.
Banana split for my baby, a glass of plain water for me. Stack her up with crazy goo, 'cause that's the stuff she likes to wade right through. Banana split for my baby, a glass of plain water for me. Now add the cherries, the kind she loves to munch. Skip one banana, use a whole darn bunch. Drown it in fudge, six or seven cans. Give her two spoons, she'll eat it with both hands. Banana split for my baby, and a glass of plain water for me. Separate checks,
it must be. Charge the split to her, the water to me. Oh, the banana splits for my baby, and the glass of plain water's for me. Ain't got no money, the glass of plain water's for me.
This podcast is proudly listed at podcastpickle.com.
That's the end. Stop the program. Stop it.